What is good, my anime people? What is good, y'all? So, with this week's episode, it's clear to me that everything we're getting with Sword Art doesn't have to be completely evolved around Kimito, and when that happens, it honestly feels like the show does dip in a little bit in quality when it comes down to having these characters share so much. They share a ridiculous amount just for us to really know that they might not even show up again. Or if they do show up again, they may play a bigger role that isn't all that big of a role. For instance, the person who actually brought Kimito into this place and needed help was the first guy who Kimito was going to during the Gun Gale arc, where he was trying to take out Death Gun. This was the guy who pretty much knew about Death Gun and was hiring Kimito, but Kimito wasn't telling anybody about it. When then he ends up in the tournament, and he's working with the sniper girl, it all starts to become a little bit more obvious that Kimito is not really there to fight anybody, but more or less fight and figure out why people are dying from, you know, a quote-unquote death gun. So there you go, a very, very small, minuscule character who also was talking to Kimito once he came out of the Sword Art Online death game. That's all he's been, right? He's just been some older adult figurehead that still has some type of workings in just VR and these virtual worlds that Kimito's into. So it's those types of things that just kind of show you that the show does keep a close tab on all of its characters, and if need be, why not just come and grab the one that need them, you know? So that's definitely what it felt like. Oh, we have an idea for another virtual world. Let's just grab this character who already knows Kimito, that already deals with virtual worlds, and it works. The one thing about this week's episode, though, I really didn't actually care for it, right? Like, I kind of called it out with me and one of my anime people that we talk all about all the animes, and I was like, it feels like after what we just saw with Kimito, he probably won't even be all that important in this week's episode, because there's so many people outside of the underworld that are doing stuff that we have no idea what they're gonna do now that things have unfolded. But just like how the person I was talking to said, they hoped the man was dead who was chasing after Owlis. Oh man, I didn't hope he was dead. I hoped he got what he deserved. In my days, did he get what he deserved, let me tell you. To get pulled down into despair, to be sucked in by all, or like pulled in by all the people that you pulled their souls from their body, it makes sense that he would get some kind of reaction with them, because he was looking at them on different, like, astral planes, right? He wouldn't just see these beings that we see, like humans with blood, flesh, and tears. He would just see them as souls, and then once he took those souls, he then understood quite a bit more about them, which, leave it to Sword Art to have such a weird concept for some human person that's supposed to be normal to just be going out and doing this, right? And being able to touch the souls of the one he's killed. I thought he would have done a little bit more out in the outside world to make me angry or something, but they didn't go that route, which is fine by me. So now it's all coming down to seeing, I don't think the black guy, maybe the black guy who got shot this week's episode did not die, and he's the one who actually got his hands on the robot and the bomb. I mean, yeah, let me talk about this robot, right? This robot who I bet no one even cared to hear about again after it already had gone out and taken all the bullets for these people. That could have been enough for me with the robot. But no, the robot then gets this chompy type of character development where all of a sudden he's making everybody cry because he's going out there and he's doing what he's got to do and he's taking the shots and not taking no meds. You know, like, bruh, please get on with it. And that's like the only time I felt that way, and that's because I don't know any of these characters besides from just Alicization, right? And I don't care for any of y'all. I've been inside the underworld with Kimito and everybody else, alright? I've been in there for like, oh, a minimum of 200 years, so I don't know these people out here. And it's one of those things where you're just kind of like, oh my god, is it really going to drag on any further? And of course, it has to drag. If you get these amazing animations, if you get a decent fight, even though the person I was talking to about all this said it was kind of cringe, which makes sense because some of those moments were pretty obvious, you know? Like, we're me and her and my anime people, we're anime lords at this point, right? So sometimes when we see something that is too good to be true, it is. Or if we see something that seems the obvious choice out of everything, it usually becomes the choice that is you've chosen. So think about that once you are watching all the shows you've ever watched, and think about how different of routes they take. You know, how many different routes have all these different animes taken from other shows that you enjoy, love, and watch over and over? Can you not spot out like six or seven of the same things that you see in those shows that you see in others? And that's kind of where I'm getting at. Once you've seen so much, you become this lord of knowledge because a lot of these creators have idols that they look up to, and those supposed idols then get their shout outs, get their, you know, showcase little bits of things that they've done in their stories that maybe these people like and do it in their stories, you know? So it is kind of hard to be fully on board and guessing what's going to happen and stuff when you kind of have an idea that it has to go one or two ways, and the way the show goes overall, it's probably not going to go in the most darkest way where Kimito loses, or Kimagaya loses, and Asuna dies, you know? There's no way they're going to go with that route, and that's the type of stuff I'm talking about is what other things happen than them losing. They win. The thing that actually got caught me off guard was they're in the game still, right? Like, this is what a lot of people want. Kimito stuck in a game, you know? Like, that's, we wanted him stuck in the death game, clearly. That's why everybody says the first season was the best season and the only season. So this is their dream come true. He's back in the game and he's stuck. So here we go. People's happy again. Well, all that being said, though, I hope you guys are having an amazing day, night, evening. I apologize, this video came a little bit longer. I took the advice of somebody who I talked to on here, and I appreciated it. So I got some good, deserved sleep. Hopefully, I don't have to go into work still. I'm on call right now, but if I do have to go to work, at least I got a lot of sleep in, and hopefully I can feel energized more than I used to. So, with all that being said, thank you everybody for the support. Your boy, the Anime G, is here to stay. And just know if I do take any long time to do stuff, I'm gonna get to it. I'm gonna get to it. No, don't sleep on me. Thank you guys so much. Take care and peace.